Well, we got an interesting problem today, and I have a couple of solutions, but I bet that you have something better. Let's hear from Michelle. She has a large file with 46,000 records. There's groups of records with the same ID, and each month she receives a new file with the new changes marked as true in a change column. So right here's a true. But Michelle doesn't need to see just the true. She needs to look at everything with that same ID. Right. So far, what has she tried? She's tried doing a filter on the change column, but that only shows us the one record, not the surrounding records. Then she tried Control F, looking for true, but then once she fixes one, she'll have to click next, 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 next. It'll be really tedious to do that. Michelle asks, is there a way to go to the next true, review the records around it, and continue through my file? Now, what we don't know, what else is in the change column. Does it just say true, which is control down arrow to get to the next one, or is there other stuff there, like no change? The first idea builds on Michelle's idea. Let's choose the whole column, control F, look for true, but I'm not gonna click find next. Instead, I'm gonna look for find all. All right, so this dialog box is interesting. It can stay open here in the background while we continue to work in Excel. And it's resizable, all right? So the advantage of this is we could fix one. Go to D655 and fix those records. And then to get to the next one, I can just click in the dialog box here to jump to the next true. What I don't particularly like is that it's always just barely scrolling that true into view, so I'm going to have to use the wheel mouse to pull it back up to eye level each time, all right? So that's method number one, is use find all instead of find. All right, or here's a completely different way to go. We could use the advanced filter. So we have this data set over here with change, and sometimes there's the word true. So I'm gonna build a criteria range with change in G1 and true just below it, and then an output range of the identifier. So I wanna get a list of all the identifiers that changed. So over here, we go to data, advanced filter. We're gonna copy to another location. The criteria range, in this case, is gonna be G1 to G2. And the copy to is gonna be I1. Click OK, and that gets us a list of all of the identifiers that have a change this month. And then we're gonna do a second advanced filter. This time we're gonna filter the list in place. The criteria range is no longer that two-cell range with change and true. Instead, it's gonna be the identifiers that we found in step one. And click OK. All right, took a little bit longer to filter that time. So here we have a true for A8177 and all of those show up. A true for 6859 and all of those show up. A true for S9150 and the records above and below show up. Here we have a larger group of I2731 and all of those show up. All right, so now we've condensed this 46,000 rows down to just the ones that you have to pay attention to. All right, so those are the two methods that I came up with, either control F and find all and then use the dialog box to move through, or this method using advanced filter twice. I bet you have something better for this. I felt like there should be a formula I should be able to write in a new column E, but I kept getting circular references. So let me know. Let me know how you would solve Michelle's problem. Hey, thanks to everyone who checked out my new book, Mr. Excel 2022, Boosting Excel, just came out last week. Click that I in the top right-hand corner. Lots of new features, including those 14 new functions that came out just last week. Well, I want to thank Michelle for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Now, if you love Excel, check out my new courses on the Retrieve platform. They're video courses, but you just type what you're looking for. It takes you right to that spot in the video, and there's a complete transcript in several languages. It's a super fast way to learn.